So this video is going to cover the muscles of the forearm. So those are going to be muscles that are moving the wrist, the fingers, or those that are involved in pronation and supination. I think out of all of the muscles, students find the muscles of the forearm the most frustrating to learn. However, the nice thing about them is that once you know the names, you also know the actions. A little silver lining right there. So to orient myself on the forearm, I always start by identifying some of the muscles I know from the upper arm, specifically the biceps brachii. And then right next to the biceps brachii is the brachioradialis. So once I find the brachioradialis, I know the next one over is the pronator teres. And then next to that is the flexor carpi radialis, because it's doing flexion, it's going to the wrist, and it's on the radial side, so it's on the thumb side. So because I have a flexor carpi radialis, if I flip to the other side, I can see from this angle a tiny piece of the flexor carpi ulnaris. And then in between the two, going right to the palm, is the palmaris longus. So once I locate the flexor carpi ulnaris, from this angle we can still see flexor carpi radialis, palmaris longus, and then flexor carpi ulnaris. Right next to that is the extensor carpi ulnaris, because now it's not attaching to the anterior side, it's not attaching to the palm side of my arm, it's attaching to the dorsal side, so it's going to pull the hand back. It's going to cause extension at the wrist. So flipping around again, there's the extensor carpi ulnaris, which is right next to the extensor digitorum. If you just follow it up, you can clearly see it's going to all the digits. And then next to the extensor digitorum, there's the extensor carpi radialis brevis. And it's the extensor carpi radialis brevis because right next to it is the extensor carpi radialis longus. And once we reach that, we're back to the beginning where we started at the brachioradialis. And once again, the brachioradialis is super easy to find because it's right next to the brachialis and right next to the biceps brachii. So what we've mentioned so far with our extensors have been things that are extending the wrist or extending the digits, but then these two last muscles are going to the thumb. So it's the extensor pollicis brevis and the abductor pollicis longus. So that takes care of everything superficially. So we can go back to our starting point. And if you remove the pronator teres and the flexor carpi radialis and the palmaris longus, deep to that is the flexor digitorum superficialis. Some students are confused as to why something that has superficial in the name is deep to some other muscles, but it's the flexor digitorum superficialis because is the flexor digitorum profundus. Profundus meaning profound or deep. And then next to the flexor digitorum profundus on the thumb side is the flexor pollicis longus. And last but not least, when you remove the brachioradialis, you can see how the pronator teres is crossing over and has its attachment point on the radius, which is why it's able to rotate the radius and pronate the palm. And then, with its fibers going in the opposite direction of the pronator teres, under the brachioradialis is the supinator. So the supinator is going to pull the radius back in the opposite direction and supinate the palm. So that wraps it up for the muscles of the forearm. I know it can seem very confusing at first because they're long names, but they weren't named that way to torture you. They were named that way because it's very descriptive of where the muscle is and what it does. So if you try to think of it like that, it should make it a little easier to remember because then you're not memorizing, you're understanding. All right, have a great day and have fun studying.